What can I do to not go stir crazy right now? One of my clients called me today and asked me, what can I do? Because I really, really go insane. I'm trying to work on my business. It's quite busy, actually. I need to do a lot of stuff, but my children are at home, my wife is at home, and everything and everyone is driving me nuts. So what can I do? Well, there are a couple of things you actually can do. And one of the things I personally really like is to wake up early in the morning. Set my alarm a bit earlier before my family actually wakes up. In that precious time, I can actually really, really come up with new strategies, new ways of working, because it is really silence. Nobody is asking me for my attention. Nobody is actually awake yet. So it's really, really this silence that helps me to think. It's also for me my ideal time to work out and to meditate and to think strategically. So that's the first thing I could share with you that really sets you up for a better day. It is waking up early and having some time for yourself. Now, the second thing I would urge you to do is when you feel everything is getting too much and you really, really start to feel the pressure building up in yourself, before shouting it out and before really, really exploding, just tell people around you that you need some space. It may be for a half hour, it may be for an hour, whatever you need. Whether you need it to work on something, whether you need it personally, whether you need it mentally, it doesn't really matter, but just tell them, I need this half hour, I'm gonna be here in my room or in the bedroom or whenever, just leave me be, and after that I will be refreshed and I will be all eyes for you. That's the second tip. If you can, I would even invite you to go out to have some time on your own. Just be careful of keeping your distance and going by yourself and not going to crowded places. But that's also a very proven way to get some clarity and sanity back. And then the last thing, because we know that a lot of us are living in confined small apartments, people really, really close to each other. And that's almost like the reason why things get out of hand, because we are too much and too often in each other's proximity. So what I then would recommend you is these. It's like a lifesaver for a lot of us, and especially for those who need their personal space. You can always pop in your headphones. And if you're working on something, choose to listen to focus music, because that really gets you going. If you just want a break from it all, turn on your favorite tunes and maybe dance along. Or if you want to learn something, turn on an audiobook. There are many, many ways to actually close yourself off for a while to avoid you going insane and exploding and making the situation worse. These are my tips for the question of the day. How do I stop myself from going insane within these four walls? If you have any other questions or any other tips, or you found value in this video, please let me know underneath. Or if you want my personal coaching to help you through these times of adversity and to make sure that you and your business will be thriving, send me a DM and we can set up a quick call to help you and to see what you need right now. Bye for now.